And welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today's video is going to be a Q&A about living and moving to Turkey. If you're new here on my channel, I'm a Dutch girl and I'm living in Marmaris, Turkey. And I always get a lot of questions about moving to Turkey or how life is here in Turkey. So I thought let's film another Q&A. I filmed one of these quite a while ago, but I always get still a lot of questions. So I thought let's make another one so everything is clear. And yes, I really hope you guys enjoy this video, and if you're excited to see this video, don't forget to give the huge thumbs up. You really help my channel with it. And if you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you subscribe. I upload twice a week, every Wednesday and Saturday. And now let's get started with the video. So I got some questions here on YouTube and also some on my Instagram, so I'm gonna pick a few of them. Also, some questions are in Dutch, so I will translate it. And the first question is, welke stad in Turkije zou je graag willen bezoeken en waarom? And it means which city in Turkey I would like to visit and why. So I live in Marmaris in the province Muğla, which is in the southwest of Turkey. And I haven't been to Ankara yet or Istanbul. I've been to Istanbul airport, but not in the city of Istanbul. So I would really like to visit Istanbul and Ankara. But I'm not a huge fan of really big cities. So on the top of my list is Cappadocia. And Cappadocia looks so beautiful. It has like all different rocks, and in those rocks are churches from a really long time ago. And it just looks amazing there. And I would also like to visit Efes, which is also a really old city, and they still haven't discovered everything of that city. So I would really love to visit that. And Efes is not too far from here, so hopefully if the virus is going a bit better, I can travel here in Turkey. So they are on my list for sure. Then the next question is, how did you learn Turkish? So I'm still learning Turkish. I understand quite a bit, so I can make conversations with people about like daily life. But if I want to talk like more deep conversation, it's getting a bit hard for me still. So I'm far from perfect yet. But I think the best way to learn it is just to talk Turkish and to practice it daily. And I'm really lucky, of course, that I have a Turkish husband, so I can practice with him. Although I have to say, we talk half Turkish, half English still, so I really have to work on that. But definitely with my mother-in-law, I can practice with her a lot. And I think that's the best way, just do it. And I also have an app, Duolingo. I also made a video about it, and that's a really nice app that you can practice like a few minutes a day. And I think that's a really nice way to learn a new language. So I think the best tip I can give you is just to practice it daily. Then the next question is, when did you decide to move to Turkey? So like I already said, my husband is Turkish, so that's how I ended up here. And it's really hard to get a visa in the Netherlands for him. So the best option was that I moved to him instead of he moved to the Netherlands. So that's why I decided to come to Turkey, and I haven't regretted. I really love to live here. I think it's a beautiful country, and yes, I would really recommend living here. The weather is amazing, and yeah, I think it's a beautiful country to live in. Then the next question is in Dutch again, and she asked me, hoe heb je verblijfsvergunning geregeld? So it means, how did I get my visa? If you don't know this, if you come to Turkey, you need a visa. If you come for a holiday, you can really easily get that online. I believe they don't do it at the airport anymore. They did that, but unfortunately not anymore. So you need to do it on the internet. And it's about 20 euros. And then you can stay, I believe, 3 months in Turkey. Then you have to leave Turkey. And then I believe you can come for another 90 days. I'm not really sure if that changed, but when I came here, I had just a 90 days visa. And my husband and I got married, so it was really easy for me to get a visa because I was married with a Turkish man. And I would say on internet, you can find all the paperwork that you need for it. If you are not married with a Turkish person, a man or a woman, I believe then it's harder. Then you need a lot of like money in your bank and all of that, and a lot more proof like why you want to live here. and my visa is still for 2 years, and I've been living here almost 5 years, so I will apply for a passport soon, which is really scary because I need to go for an interview and all of that, so I'm really nervous for that, I'm not gonna lie. But yes, it will be nice if I also become Turkish, because then I never need to apply again for a visa. And a visa is also quite expensive now. It was cheaper when I came here, but it's gone up the price. So it will be nice if I have a passport. But yes, there's a lot of different visas here, so you can definitely check the internet which one you want to get. But yes, if you are married, it's more easy, I think. Then the next question is, how were your first days in Turkey like? So it was really hard to say goodbye to my family. I cried a lot. It felt like I'm never going to see them again, which is of course not true, but yes, it was really hard. So yes, the first few days were hard but also exciting. So everything was new, like a new home, a new country, new people, which were all really nice. And I was finally with my husband, or my boyfriend at the time. So yes, that was just the best feeling, but also a bit sad because I had a lot of cards from everyone in the Netherlands, and when I tried to read them I already cried again. So definitely a double feeling. It was hard but also really exciting, so I will describe it like that. So then the next question is, what do you miss most of the Netherlands? So definitely my family. And the Netherlands as a country, yeah, I miss some things of it, like sometimes the food, like stroopwafels, bitterballen, like that kind of things, hagelslag, all typical Dutch food. I miss that. Sometimes I miss like riding a bike, just to go with a bike somewhere. In the Netherlands we use the bikes a lot, and yeah, sometimes I miss that, I guess. But yeah, most of all just my family, that I can't go for a cup of coffee to my mom, father or sister or my grandparents. Like yeah, I miss that the most, I think. Then the next question is, hey, which is the best quality that Turkey has, which makes it unique and different? So I think the weather for sure. Obviously Turkey is a really big country, so it really depends on where you live. But like I said, I live in the southwest of Turkey, so I think the weather is amazing, that I live close to the sea, that I can swim in the summer. I think that's just amazing. And the people are really nice here, and especially if you live here and like trying to talk to them in Turkish, they really like that. And the food is amazing here. Turkish food, I really love Turkish food. Turkey has a lot of beautiful nature here as well, near Marmaris. You have like a waterfall. It's just all really beautiful here. And then the last question is, how does Turkey compare to where you grew up? Would you and your husband ever move to the Netherlands together, and how are the lockdown restrictions going? So let me start with the first question. How does Turkey compare to where you grew up? So obviously it's so different where I grew up. In the Netherlands, for example, it's a lot smaller. The Netherlands is a really small country, and Turkey is super big. I believe Istanbul only has like 15 million people, something like that, and the Netherlands has around 19, not all of the Netherlands. So definitely the size. And basically everything, the whole culture is really different. In the Netherlands we are really down to earth, and in the Netherlands everything is really strict and the rules are really clear. And here in Turkey everything is more chaotic, and yeah, just everything is different, I would say. Would you and your husband ever move to the Netherlands together? Well, we discussed it, and like I said, it's really hard for him to get a visa. I think our life in Turkey is really nice and great now. I don't think we will ever move to the Netherlands, but never say never. I cannot look in the future, maybe one day, but I'm not sure. I think for now we are really happy here. And then the last question is, how are the lockdown restrictions going? So right now we have like a curfew, so from 8 or 9 o'clock in the evening till 5 o'clock in the morning you can't leave your house. And then in the weekends we have like a full lockdown. So in the weekends you can't leave your house at all. Of course, if you have to work, it's different. Or if you really need something from your closest little market, then you can leave your house. But there's definitely a lot of control, a lot of police on the road. The shops are open, although the restaurants are still closed. And if you know, my husband is a chef, and I really hope for everyone who works in tourism here in Turkey that in April they will open everything again. I really hope so, because otherwise a lot of people are getting in trouble. So let's hope and pray that in April everything is a little bit back to normal. So yes, these were all of the questions, and thank you so much for everyone who asked a question. If you have another question, feel free to ask them in the comments. And I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and follow me on Instagram. And I hope to see you guys very soon in one of my other videos. Bye!